Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. This is on the module 5, radiation heat transfer, lecture number 7. We will solve few problems, radiation between two surfaces problems. That means we are going to solve few problems on the radiation between two surfaces. In the previous lecture, we recap, we discussed the radiation between black surfaces and we derived the equation for calculating radiation heat transfer between black surfaces. Similarly, we calculated the equation, we derived the equation for radiation heat transfer to calculate the radiation heat transfer between the gray surfaces. And this lecture, we are going to solve problems. So, at the end of this lecture, you will be able to solve problem on the radiation heat transfer between two surfaces on your own. We take example number 14. Consider a cubical furnace of size 4 meter by 4 meter by 4 meter whose surfaces are closely approximate to your black surfaces. The base, top and the side surfaces are maintained at temperature of 800 Kelvin, 1500 Kelvin and 500 Kelvin respectively. Determine A. Net radiation heat transfer between the base and the top surface. B. Net radiation heat transfer between the base and the side surfaces. And the C. Radiation heat transfer from the base surface. So, here this is the diagram for the problem. The base is considered as one surface. The top surface is considered as one surface. The side surfaces, all the four side surfaces combined, they are considered as one surface, that is the third surface. The surface, base surface is at a temperature 800 Kelvin, the top surface is at a temperature 1500 Kelvin, and the side surfaces, it is at temperature 500 Kelvin. So, the T1 equal to 800 Kelvin, T2 equal to 1500 Kelvin, and T3 equal to 500 Kelvin, and size of the object. So, the every side, it is a cubical furnace, the side equal to A. Now, we have to calculate the shape factor between surface 1 and 2. So, this is a square plate. This is also a square plate. So, the heat transfer between plate 1 and 2 and the x-axis ratio, smaller side or diameter due to the distance between the plane. So, smaller side, the cube is side, all the sides are equal. So, smaller side is equal to the distance. So, the ratio equal to 1. So, for 1, referring to the graph, the value is 0.2. So, the shape factor between the surface 1 and 2 is 0.2. Now, the shape factor between the surface 1 and 2, so 1 and 2, this is 0.2. And from the summation rule, so we have from the surface, right? So, F11 plus F12 plus F13 equal to 1. So, from that we can calculate F13, that is shape factor between surface 1 and 3 is equal to 1 minus F11 minus F12. And this equal to 1 minus F11 equal to 0. So, F11 means amount of energy leaving the surface 1 that falls on the same surface 1, that is equal to 0. So, F12 we calculated earlier as 0.2. So, F13 equal to 0.8. So, from the graph F12 equal to 0.2, from the summation rule F13 equal to 0.8. This is what the shape factor. Now, the net radiation heat transfer between base and the top surface. So, Q12 equal to A1 F12 sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4. It is a black surface. So, 4 into 4 into 0.2 into 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 800 to the power 4 minus 1500 to the power 4. That is equal to minus of 8,44,222.2 watts. So, the negative sign significance. The heat is falling on the surface 1. So, the equation is Q12, that is heat transfer from surface 1 to 2. We are getting a negative value. That means heat is falling on the surface 1. So, heat is transferred from the surface 2 to the surface 1. Now, the net radiation heat transfer between base and the side surfaces. So Q13 equal to A1 F13 into sigma into T1 to the power 4 minus T3 to the power 4. Which is 4 into 4 into 0.8, F13 equal to 0.8, sigma equal to 5.61 10 power minus 8 into 800 to the power 4 minus 500 to the power 4, which is 251911.3 watts. Now, the radiation heat transfer of the surface from the base surface, Qi equal to, we have the general equation, Qi equal to j equal to 1 to n, Qij equal to Q11 plus Q12 plus Q13. So Q11 equal to 0. Q11 means the amount of heat energy leaving the surface 1 that falls on the surface 1 again, it is equal to 0. So Q12 we have calculated, Q13 we have calculated, substituting the value equal to minus 325,310.9 watts. So the answer for the problem, net radiation heat transfer between the base and the top surface, Q12 equal to minus 844,222.2 watts. Net radiation heat transfer between the base and the side surfaces, Q13 equal to 251,913 watts, and the radiation heat transfer from the base surface, Q1 equal to minus 325,310.9 watts. And example 15, two very long parallel plates are maintained at temperature, uniform temperature of 600 degrees Celsius and 400 degrees Celsius, and the emissivity of 0.5 and 0.8 respectively. Determine the net radiation heat exchange, heat transfer between the two surfaces per unit area. And we have two surfaces, T1, T2 are 600 degrees Celsius and 400 degrees Celsius, epsilon 1 equal to 0.5 and epsilon 2 equal to 0.8, and F12 equal to F21 equal to 1 for very long parallel plates, and substituting in the equation, this equal to 5.67 into 873 to the power max, 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 873 to the power 4 minus 673 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 is 0.1 by 0.5 plus 1 by 0.8 minus 1, that is 9.47 kilowatts per meter square. The answer is the amount of heat transfer per unit area is 9.47 kilowatts per meter square. We take the next example, example number 16. Two very long concentric cylinders of inner diameter 0.2 meter and outer diameter 0.5 meter are maintained at a uniform temperature of 800 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin and have emissivity of 0.9 and 0.7 respectively. Determine the net rate of radiation heat exchange between the cylinders per unit length. So the given data is D1 equal to 0.2 meter, D2 equal to 0.5 meter, T1 equal to 800 Kelvin, T2 equal to 400 Kelvin, epsilon 1 equal to 0.9 and epsilon 2 equal to 0.7. The net radiation heat transfer between the cylinders, writing the equation Q net equal to sigma A1 into T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus R1 by R2 into 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. Sigma is 5.67 10 power minus 8, area equal to pi d into L, pi d1 into L1, L, so pi into 0.2 into 1 meter into 800 to the power 4 minus 400 to the power 4 divided by 1 by 0.9 plus 0.1 to 0.1 divided by 0.25. We have to substitute here the radius, whereas diameter is given R1 equal to 0.1 meter and R2 equal to 0.25 meter, multiplied by 1 by 0.7 minus 1, and calculating the amount of heat transfer equal to 0.67 kilowatts. The answer is heat transfer per unit length equal to 0.67 kilowatt per meter. And example number 17, two concentric spheres of diameter 0.8 meter and 1.2 meter have surface temperature of 450 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin respectively. If the surface emissivity are 0.5 and 0.05 respectively, determine net radiation heat exchange between the two spheres. So the given data, diameter, inner diameter is 0.8 meter, outer diameter is 1.2 meter, inner surface temperature is 450 Kelvin, outer surface temperature is 300 Kelvin, emissivity of the inner sphere is 0.5 and the emissivity of the outer sphere epsilon 2 equal to 0.05, and writing the equation, heat transfer equal to sigma into A1 to T1 to the power 4 minus T2 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon into R1 square by R2 square into 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So sigma equal to 5.67 into 10 power minus 8, area is 4 pi r square. So for a sphere, 4 pi r square, so 4 pi r1 square, so 4 into pi into R1 equal to 0.4 meter, So 0.4 square into 450 to the power 4 minus 300 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 is 1 by 0.5 plus R1 square equal to 0.4 square divided by 0.6 square R2 square into 1 by 0.05 minus 1, which is 359 watts. So the radiation heat transfer between the inner and the outer spheres are 359 watts. And example number 18, this is from Anna University question paper in May 2017. The surfaces of double-walled spherical vessel used for storing liquid oxygen are covered with a layer of silver having an emissivity of 0.03. The temperature of the outer surface of the inner wall is minus 153 degrees Celsius and the temperature of inner surface of the outer wall is 27 degrees Celsius. We have two spheres. The inner surface temperature is 150, T1 equal to minus 153 and T2 equal to 27 degrees Celsius. The spheres are 21 centimeter and 30 centimeter diameter with the space between them evacuated. Calculate the radiation heat transfer through the wall into the vessel and the rate of evaporation of liquid oxygen if its rate of vaporization is 220 kilojoules per kilogram. And the given data, inner diameter of the sphere is 0.21 meter, outer diameter of the sphere is 0.3 meter, inner surface temperature is minus 153 degrees Celsius, which is 120 Kelvin, outer surface temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. The emissivity of the two surfaces, epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2 equal to 0.03, and the latent heat of vaporization is 220 kilojoules per kilogram for oxygen. And the inner surface area of the sphere, A1 equal to pi D1 square, this is equal to 3.4 into 0.21 square, which is 0.1385 meter square. And the heat transfer between the inner and the outer and the inner sphere here, because the outer surface is higher temperature, inner surface is lower temperature, always the heat is leaking from the outer sphere to the inner sphere. So, it is sigma A1 into T2 to the power 4 minus T1 to the power 4 divided by 1 by epsilon 1 plus R1 square by R2 square into 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1 substituting 5.6 on 10 power minus 8 into area equal to 0.1385 into 300 to the power 4 minus 120 to the power 4 divided by 1 by 0.03 plus 0.0105 divided by 0.15 square into 1 by 0.03 minus 1. This is 1.281. The amount of heat leaking from the outer sphere to the inner sphere is 1.28 watts. And with that heat energy, the amount of oxygen, liquid oxygen evaporated, M equal to Q by HFG, which is 1.28 divided by 220 into 1000. So 220 is the latent heat of evaporation for liquid oxygen. So 220 into 1000, that equal to 5.8 10 power minus 6 kilograms per second, which is 0.02 kilograms per hour. So the answer, rate of heat transfer is 1.2 watts and rate of evaporation of the liquid oxygen is 0.02 kilograms per hour. We stop here. These are all the reference books for the subject. You can refer to the book for your further knowledge. And this is the book what I have published earlier. You can refer to the book for more problems in the subject. And you can write to me, to my mail ID. I will answer all your queries on this subject. So, thank you. We'll meet again.